the KSO Show. I'm Derek Young, this time joined by Drew Galloway as we discuss what we heard. We'll do this every Tuesday throughout the season because Tuesday is when we get to speak to Chris Klieman for his weekly press conference previewing the game, you know, and in this case this week it's Stanford, of course. We also heard from several players, whether it be Skylar Thompson, I believe Cooper Beebe, Deuce Vaughn, Julius Brandt, Echo Boydeau, Russ East, Eli Huggins. I'm probably missing maybe one or two as well. So we heard from a lot of different folks. And I guess the one takeaway that I had, at least from a defensive perspective, and we'll start on that side of the ball, I thought a prevailing takeaway that we heard often was that this unit's going to play much faster.
Yeah, that was one thing that was really echoed throughout the entire press conference from every single defensive player, Chris Klieman, and they all talked about how they're playing faster, they're communicating better, and those are all extremely good things to hear, especially with so many new faces on the defense that they're communicating and playing fast.
Yeah, communication is going to be key. A lot of new faces, some of them being Reggie Stubblefield, Sincere Mason, Julius Brandt, Timmy Horn, who just got elected captain, even though he hasn't been with the program for even a full year yet, so that says a lot about him. And another thing that'll help them play faster, of course, is having a lot of guys to rotate in and out. We know that they've done that in the past at the linebacker spot. They've done it in the secondary a little bit less in the defensive line the last couple of seasons, but they should be able to do that this year. It sounds like maybe a little bit more depth at the defensive line than they had in the prior two seasons. Chris Klieman even noted they could play up to 10 different players along the defensive front.
Yeah, that was one thing that has been kind of echoed throughout the entire offseason, is that the defensive line might not have as much talent, but they're as deep at the position as they've ever been. I think Eli Huggins, one of the things that he said is that they usually bring 5 defensive tackles to road games, and he thinks that all 5 could play and play meaningful snaps, which says a lot. I think the defensive tackle room is probably the best that it's been in the Chris Klieman era.
Yeah, I mean, that's certainly how Mike Tuiasosopo felt when we spoke to him last week. He echoed the same thing. I think we heard Chris Klieman share today even something that Coach Tui also shared, and the fact that Robert Hintz is going to play a pivotal role for the Wildcats this season, have one of the best off seasons of any defensive lineman. Defensive ends obviously have to replace Wyatt Hubert, but just as deep, I think we're going to see quite a bit out of Nate Matlack and Felix Onodike.
Yeah, you're going to see a lot of the two of them. You're going to see a lot of the Khalid Dukes and Boom Massies. And I think that even Spencer Trussell could play a big role this season. We've heard good things about him. He came on really strong last season after kind of being way back in the rotation and played a pretty big role in some of the games last season.
Something I loved to hear as well was Echo Boydeau kind of coming out of a shell a little bit this time. He's a little bit more reserved in media settings typically, but today's session you could definitely tell he was a much more comfortable, much more mature, and just had a different presence about him. Obviously a year of starting and being a pretty good corner is a pretty good way to do that. He even said he's still the fastest player on the team and said it wasn't even close, so that shows just the confidence kind of seeping through him at this point. And even he addressed his excitement about playing across from Julius Brandt. He said last year he didn't get a lot of action. Teams wanted to stay away from him. He doesn't feel like that's going to happen this year. He said just because of the presence and the length and how good Julius Brandt has already shown him to be in practice, he actually expects to be the guy targeted the most.
Which kind of goes along with what everybody said, that Julius Brandt is the next guy that is going to be probably an NFL player. He has the size. That's one of the most common things that's been said throughout Julius Prince's time here, is how good he is, and it's came from every single player, which is honestly really impressive.
Yeah, another question that was common, and I know I asked it a few times, especially some of the new transfers, because sometimes they can feel like maybe they have to do a little too much. They have something to prove. We asked a lot of the players if they felt like they had something to prove, and I really liked the answer. You know, obviously that Skylar Thompson gave, he doesn't feel like he has anything to prove at this stage of his career, but even the new transfers, Russ East and Julius Brandt, they did admit that they're probably a little bit more jacked up for this game just because they are on a new team and Stanford is the one on the other sideline, but they also said they don't really have anything to prove. More than anything, they don't want to prove anyone wrong. They wanted to prove themselves right.
Yeah, that shows the mindset of this team. I think that they're as good. They're in a really good mental place, and this is probably the best culture-wise that it's been for a little bit. And you can see that in all the players' faces too, because everybody's smiling, everybody's having a good time talking to us, and we'll see how that goes when adversity strikes, but right now it's hard to not like the mental makeup of this team.
I would agree. Offensively now, as we switch gears, already touched a little bit on Skylar Thompson and what he had to say. I thought what Chris Klieman said about the receiver rooms, and I know this isn't maybe a sexy name or a flashy name that's going to excite people, but you could really, really tell the respect and the adoration and how impressed he has been by Landry Weber over the course of the last 3 or 4 weeks.
Yeah, and that kind of goes along with what or how he played in 2019, because he didn't have very many catches, but it felt like the catches that he had were in big spots. I put on the board yesterday that I remember a pass on a third long against Mississippi State that he caught and converted, and K-State ended up scoring. And then if you look back at some of the bigger runs that K-State had last season, a lot of that was sparked by a Landry Weber block. So I think he's the best blocker in the receiver room, and he has a lot of clutch catches already.
First time we got to speak to Deuce Vaughn in a while, and he echoed what we've heard about DJ Giddens, believing that he is a true freshman that has a chance to make an impact, at least in some form, this season. I thought it was interesting, too. I asked him, because I hadn't had a chance, you know, how much different is running behind this offensive line? It was the same one as it was a year ago, just to see how much progress they had made. And he agreed, like, and he said a lot of it has just to do with cohesion, being able to, you know, kind of know what his offensive linemen are going to do. He knows more about what he's doing, which makes them better, but he also knows which way they're going to go. There's a little bit of an unspoken chemistry that they have now that allows them to be more effective and him to be more effective. And I also told him, you know, point out one or two guys. I said, I know that whole room's, you know, improved immensely. That's why a lot of people view it as the strength of the offense. But I said, what's one or two guys I've just blown you away, because how much better they are from now as compared to last season. And I know one of those guys he brought up was Christian Duffy, and obviously he's going to start at right tackle and be a focal point for the Wildcats moving forward. And although they're going to miss this guy for the rest of the season because he injured himself during fall camp, the other one was Taylor Portier.
And that kind of echoes along with everything that we've heard, that Christian Duffy was one of the immediate locked-in starters from the start of spring. And then throughout the fall camp, he's really impressed. And then we've obviously heard good things about Taylor Poitier, even though he injured himself during fall camp. But he's going to be really impressive, and I'm really excited about his future.
And I know Chris Klieman touched on it also a little bit today. He mentioned it and made note of it because he was asked about it. But what's the status on Sebastian Taylor for the Saturday's game against Stanford?
So he's going to be on a pitch count, is what it sounds like, and that they like the depth that they have in the receiver room, and they think that they can play 6-7 guys at receiver, so like they don't feel rushed with Sebastian Taylor to make him play 45 plays a game, and that he might not be on the field as much as he probably wants to be, but it's probably best because of all the depth that they have at the receiver room to kind of let him ease into it and try and get his mental state back, because that's honestly as important as his physical state coming off of that injury.
Yeah, that's when he really raved about Landry Weber as a guy that they can rely upon. Of course, you have Malik Knowles, and you have Phillip Brooks. Keenan Garber was raved about by a few guys, especially Rush East as a guy who has to cover him on a regular basis, of course. And then, you know, the wide receiver room in general is probably still a bit of a work in progress, just because they are working some guys back into the mix, such as Sebastian Taylor. But combined with what you said revealed about what Chris Klieman had to say today about Sebastian Taylor's status, probably being on a pitch count of sort, seeing him on the two line, you know, on the depth chart that was released on Monday, I think we can anticipate Sebastian Taylor probably not starting, probably getting anywhere from, I would guess, around 10 to 15 snaps, nothing absurd, but he's not going to be an afterthought either. You could tell Skylar Thompson's maturity, experience, you know, being in this room before, answering questions before, he's probably the most comfortable at doing it at this point.
Oh yeah, I'd agree with that, but I also think that he looks more comfortable this year than any other year, because like, it used to feel like he would kind of ramble and like try and find an answer, but this year he seems laser focused and it feels like more genuine with all of us, and I think that proves, or that comes with his experience and also comes with the excitement around this team that everybody's had.
Yeah, his answers are sharper and more succinct now, too. I also thought there was an ease and a comfort and a more you know, noticeable, matured and handled and confident presence with Cooper Beebe as well. You know, you're in your first year or two answering questions from the media, it can be overwhelming, and those guys don't always look comfortable. I think last year we could say Echo, it was even through Zoom, Echo Bordeaux did not look comfortable. Cooper Beebe did not look comfortable. Who else did we see? I don't know if we saw anyone else today that we can compare, but those two remarkably looked much different in how they handled the questions and how much more confident they were, and how much more at ease and comfortable. And you could tell that they're probably assuming some kind of leadership. Deuce Font, another younger player we heard today, but obviously he was pretty comfortable with us a year ago as well. So that wasn't a large difference. One last note I would like to make in terms of an observation from today, as we did get to see Julius Brents, and we spoke to him in person as well. His size and his length is every bit that everyone's been saying. That dude is huge.
Oh, yeah, he's a big physical presence. I don't think K-State's ever had a corner as big or as long as Julius Brents, maybe ever.
Yeah, even Echo Bordeaux said, because I asked Echo, I was like, you still a fast in the room? I'm like, yes. I was like, but you're not the longest anymore. He's like, no, that's Julius Brents. That dude's 6'3". He might be 6'4", as long as his arms are just as long. It's pretty phenomenal. We'll have much more coverage throughout the day, throughout the week. More KSO shows. We'll have more podcasts. We'll have more video. We'll have more written content as well. Keep it locked on KSO. For Drew Galloway, I'm Derek Young. And always remember to tell your friends.